For joining us. I'm Jo Wilderman here, of course, with Michael Ray. We're backstage at the Grand Ole Opry doing something that's the first of its kind. This is the first simulcast of an album preview. That album, of course, is Amos, which comes out this Friday. I know the Opry is such a special place to you. Tell us about your love for Opry.
Yeah, you know, it was my grandfather's name, Amos, and so when it comes to my story, it was him. You know, I feel like he kind of planted that seed for me way before I even came along with the family's band and what he, you know, his love and passion for country music and the Grand Ole Opry. He was the one that taught me about the Grand Ole Opry, the significance of the Grand Ole Opry, what it meant to country music. And I made my opera debut April 24th of 2015. And, this is the stage that you never get used to playing. It's always, the feelings are always the first time, the nerves are always the first time. When you step on the stage, you're not just playing your songs, but you're representing country music, and for that time around, you're representing the men and women of the Grand Ole Opry. And it's something I don't take lightly, and it's an honor just to be here, and it's an honor for me to be the first one to be, to have my album broadcast live all over all the socials. So.
Take us back to your debut here on Opry.
My debut, my grandfather passed away February 4th of that year, so a couple months before we were able to, and he was one, like I said, sit watching the VHSs of Grand Ole Opry with Minnie Pearl and Stringbean and Roy Acuff and Grandpa Jones and Marty Stewart. And it was always that thing of, hey, I don't know how you get there from Eustis, Florida, but if we ever do, we're going to do it together, you know? And so after he passed away, it was about 3 weeks later, I got the email to pick your opera debut date. And, so it was like, man, we were so close. But on my debut, I was able, thanks to the Grand Ole Opry, to honor him in probably a bigger way than I could have if he was here with us. And I had my family with me. One of the moments I remember, I debuted playing his guitar that he played for 50 years, and did Green Grass at Home, Porter Wagoner's version. And I remember finishing it. It was obviously emotional, and I looked over, and my dad was standing right back here, and my uncle. My grandmother's in a wheelchair, and then Ricky Skaggs was standing right next to her. And I was like, this is not a normal day at the office. So it was something very special. My first time stepping in the circle was with my dad and my uncle. So it was just a big day of celebrating and being able to make your opera debut.
Very special. We have people out in the audience.
Girl, well, I can hide it for real, 'cause I don't know if you understand. got a song that nobody else knows. So just follow it, baby, wherever it goes. It's gonna hurt to let you go, but baby, go fly. So high, so high. I can watch you dancing forever, turning those stars into letters. Wrapping names in the sky. When you laugh, when you cry, just get that breeze like a feather. Turn your tears into treasures. When you're here, when you're gone, well, I'll be here, looking on. So keep on dancing.
The skies have spread your wings, cause this tale's too small. Stars in the moon, well girl, I hope you got them all.
Sweet for now.
where you thought I'd be. You drive around till you found me. If it took all night, you press to your lips, say you never felt like this, and I'd be all you need. And you get drunk on me.
Streets, traffic so strong, baby, folks like me on the job for my